Okay, guys. We have another speaker, and this is really amazing speaker. Some of you never heard about him before, but you will. Because this guy is the founder and the CEO of UpSteam, which is one of the fastest growing early stage startups of Estonia. Well, he was getting his bachelor's in international business. He used to sell books door to door with Southwestern company. After three summers, three sizzlers, mom's awards, dedication awards, state deals, and all the other fun stuff, he founded UpSteam with other two alumni, Bookman, Alexis, Anyar, and Valio Kut, who both also sold for four summers. They're building the future of car washing by bringing car washing services to people's doorsteps. They started by building just one car van that cleaned cars with steam. Now they have a team of 50 plus people in two countries, Estonia and Finland. They've raised close to 1.7 million euros in investor capital, and they're hitting 50 grand revenue per month. Some fun facts about Martin Kristerson. He finished the Vohadu 100 kilometer kayak marathon in 13 hours without having to sit into kayak ever before in his life. He also has done planking exercise for 66 minutes. I have commitment with my friends. We do it for 3 minutes. I've done it 5 minutes the most. He did 66. He was promoted as a three-stripe sergeant when he was serving in the Estonian military, and he recruited five people in total and got engaged with one of them, Laura Vaske. So give great, amazing applause to Martin Kristerson!
Crazy.
Okay, well, yes, thank you for calling me and said Martin, come over, speak a little bit about afterlife of Southwestern Advantage. I've been away from the business for 3 years now, but it's great to be back. I want to ask you guys one question. Are people still buying books?
No.
Yeah. Okay. Did people buy books?
Yeah!
But that's not the Southwestern Advantage I remember. Make me really believe, guys. Are people buying books?
Yeah!
Very good, very good. I hope you guys are going to sell a lot. Well, like every good presentation, I don't have any slides. So it's going to go from speaking at least, but I'm gonna go start along with one Southwestern book pit story as well, like everybody does. So I think I really did thought about like what was the story I want to give you guys. And I see there's a lot of new faces, a lot of the old faces probably know all of me by now. But the most important story for me, I think, takes me back to my first summer. That's when I think it was like the second or third week selling books. And I believe I had like two or three very unique customers, you know, that I just desperately signed up with money orders.
Very good stuff.
So basically I had like zero units, but I was working in a very low income, like not somewhere like where people and then suddenly I ended up in a very, very high income per day. I was working in South Carolina, and it was like 40 plus degrees outside, so making like a snowman. You guys probably know.
But, South Carolina!
Yes, good turf. But yes,
I went to this very high income place. By 12 o'clock, I believe I had like 3 approaches. Just because nobody answered the door, you could see the butler, but that doesn't count. And then I had my lunch, or we call it breakfast or whatever, and I took out my salad box. It was rotten. I was so, so sad. And then I sat on this pavement curb, and having 0 units, so fucking hot outside. No demos, because you know, I really wanted to get my 30 demos. And I had 0 demos as well. Then I looked into the sky and I saw this plane fly. And then I started crying. I really wanted to be on that damn plane. Because that was the most critical part for me when I realized, like, what did I actually goddamn sign up? That was so tough. And I felt like, why on earth am I doing this? Sitting here on a plane and crying like a baby just came from military with 3 stripes. It was desperate. And I made a decision. I said to myself that even if I'm not going to sell one book this summer, I'm going to finish this summer, and I'm here forever. And that was my biggest highlight from all my 3 summers, which have really walked with me until today, and probably in the future as well. So, some of you probably know cleaning cars, car wash guy. So we've been in business for 3 years. Business is booming. Could be always better, but we're trying to give our best. But Southwestern Advantage gave me a lot more than just sales skills, because it also gave me a wife sitting right there, and also it gave me my business. Because it was my first summer also in South Carolina, but this was somewhere in the last part of the summer. And I was knocking on a door, and I saw this very colorful car drive next to the neighbor's house, took out the pressure washer, and started cleaning this car. And I thought to myself, you know, when you guys are out there, you probably know you have a lot to think about, right? Because you're alone with your thoughts and everything. I was looking at this car and I was wondering, like, why on earth should anyone try to have a car wash done in a different way? Because, you know, I was this poor kid from college. I had this very old, rusty Mazda 3-2F, black, nice, had a huge subwoofer, like, made good noise, headaches and stuff. But, I took my car to a car wash like maybe once a year or so for a birthday party or something like this, because you know, I looked for the cheapest voucher online and the biggest list of services, and then I went to the car wash, and then you go to this very like industrial area for the cheapest car wash, and then you know, they tell you to come back in 3 hours, and you're standing there in the middle of nowhere thinking, like, what am I doing in those 3 hours? And then that's where I got the like the pain for the idea. And then when I saw this colorful car there in the South Carolina, then I thought to myself, yes, this is a very good idea. And then, you know, since I was studying business, I did all my business plans and everything just according to the same business model. You know, I wasn't even taking it very seriously that we're gonna do it. But the more time went through, then I started feeling like, you know, we could actually do it. We could actually make it happen, because it makes so much sense. But the one thing I did not have was a key. And that's the second thing that I really appreciate getting from Southwestern, was that, you know, even though I had recruited only 5 people, but I'm really proud I had 0 quitters. Nobody's quitting on my watch. Not even a list. So, yes, I took that skill I have from Southwestern Advantage and I really appreciate getting it from here because I really believe that great things are really called great teams. And as I went to Valjovit and Alexis Anier to get them to my team, that was a groundbreaking moment for Southwestern before UpSteam, sorry. Right now, yes, we have about 50 people in our team, and we're expecting to hit between 300 to 350 in the next 18 months. So a lot to recruit, but already today I'm feeling kind of the pains of maybe being even more in recruiting when I was at Southwestern Advantage, because now is coming the time where I have to start recruiting 8+ people. And that's a fucking challenge. You know, finding those decents or those A-plus players from day one is very tough. And I wish I really had put more focus on recruiting when I was doing Southwestern as well. But yes, as I mentioned, you know, we're recruiting 300 washers, but I'm also looking for like 4 to 5 A-plus or like C-level people as well. And that's the challenge. So, in a nutshell, the point of my story is that when we're doing recruiting, there's this principle of focus. And I think recruiting really boils down to two different options. You can either recruit for quantity, or you can recruit for quality. In our sense, the 300 washers is the quantity. But when I'm talking about the 4 to 5 C-level people who, you know, in Southwestern terms, categorized as always, or something like that, or ESLs, then that's a tougher cookie. And I want to make a quick like test with you guys as well later on, but before, just kind of give you a little bit like insight on the point of my story as well. So, when you're doing recruiting, I really believe that you have, you can either recruit people into your business, or you can recruit them into your playgrounds. What I mean by that is that the purpose of a business is to provide results. And results can be money, it can also be learning, it can be any kind of results, but it has to be results driven. And I know you guys have been saying it doesn't matter how much you sell, but actually, it doesn't matter how much you sell. Let's be honest. The second option is the playground. What do we do in playgrounds? We look for friends, we look for fun. And of course, Southwestern Advantage is a perfect environment to provide with that as well. Because today in the evening, you guys are all going to probably get wasted, make new friends, and wake up in the morning next to a person like, ooh, who are you? And that's the fun part. But that's not why we are here, are we? Because we are here to learn. We are here to learn and all this kind of fun stuff. So I really want you to pick one focus and see, like, don't mix and match those things in your focus, because I'm sure a lot of you have heard about this Pareto principle. Doing 20% things will give you 80% results, but if you're here to find friends and fun, then you're probably not gonna get so much results as well. And yeah. So, figure out whether are you recruiting people into your playground or you are recruiting them into your business. And that's a massive difference in there. Let me ask you this, guys. Any recruiters here? Yep. Okay, now keep your hand up. And I'm gonna go from one first year up. And when you have less, then just drop your arm. So one first year. Cheers. Good. 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh shit. Keep it up. Really high. Can't see you. 6. Holy damn. 7. 8. 9.
Not 10 years ago. Wait, this year, okay, let's keep up those people who have 5+ people as first years in your personal team. 5+ people, okay. So, very good job, guys. Let's just pick you, you're the closest to me. How many people? 5. Okay, very good. I'm gonna grab this crayon. I'm gonna make a very cruel test with you now. Is that okay? We don't need to. Are there any of those first years here in this room?
No?
Probably not. Yes? Just ask, just in case. So, please give me the first letters of those people. You don't have to say the full name.
K.
K? Alright. Sorry?
J.
K, J.
L.
L.
B.
And V. Okay. We forgot about Victor and Valeria. Okay. Alright. Well, this is a very good test that was just recently made with me and was as well, and really made me think about what I'm gonna do is with you is that I want you to rate those people from a scale of 1 to 5, where 5 being that this person is a very good cultural fit, is a very good potential, is very independent, and everything you're looking in a first year, because you have high confidence that this person will achieve greatness as a first year. Whereas 1 means that probably not. Yep. And you have only one or two seconds to give me this rating. So let's start from K.
4.
4. J.
3.
4.
4.
5. 5. 3. Alright. Good. Very good. Now, as we're looking at those numbers, then let's analyze them a little bit. So if we're looking at V, and that was the name you forgot, but you have 5 here. So what does that say? All I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to put you into thinking whether you're recruiting for quality or quantity. Are you recruiting them into your playground or you're recruiting them into your business? And when we're looking at, we're having a lot of 4s and 5s, which is not actually really bad, which means you're making, looks like you're doing really good quality, but what it also could say is that it's a perception of your ideal first year. If you're looking at the B, Victor, he or she, I don't know, is your 5. Now imagine this guy is being your 5, and that's a matter of belief, because, you know, if I were to ask you, do you know in Southwestern Advantage, the whole company, have you ever seen a better first year than that?
Yes.
2 times better?
Yes.
3 times better?
Yes.
4 times?
Yes.
It goes unlimited, right? So one thing, if we give people these kind of ratings as 5, that tells a lot about ourselves. And that's where, when I had this test made with me, I had like 4s and 5s as well, because I really believe in my team and I want the best for them. But at the end of the day, as I mentioned, you're recruiting into your business. Business is results focused. And you as the leader have to really focus on kind of having this really honest and unfiltered rating to your people. And it's not bad if you say that Valerie is 3. Because 3 gives you the option of going up to 4, going up to 5. But this guy is completed. Nothing to do with that guy. This guy should be producing Ranol Kasaväli Club. Yes? So that's a very good like a leadership assignment. I don't really care like whether these guys are actually 4 or 3, but this is a perception of your own personal mindset. How you see your team, because if we have 5s, then these people are complete. I would say that 4s are actually the best option you want to go for, because these are the people you can work with, they have some development to go to. And 3 is where you have to make 2 decisions. If you're recruiting for business, if you're recruiting for playground, you can keep your ones and twos here as well, it doesn't matter. But if we're talking about business, then threes are either teach or replace. It's harsh. It's harsh. But you can already do that before accepting them into your team. So you don't have to go to your first year and say like, hey, Martin said you're a three, so he'll have to go. You don't have to do that. But that's also one tool to kind of see like, okay, can I teach this person to go to four? Or is it some place I need to like replace this person? It really depends on your quality levels. I mean, if you want, you can do that starting from two as well. Three maybe is totally okay for you. But one thing I'm really trying to get through your heads here is that whatever you focus on is what you're getting, right? And what your standards are is what you're getting as well. If we're talking about twos, then in UpSteam that means you're going. And that's the crappy part of being a manager, but you have to do that. Ones I wouldn't even recruit into my team. But again, if you're recruiting for your playground, it's all up to you, right? So how do we get those one or threes or four or fives? Probably four or fives means that you're working for quality. Yeah? That's what I was doing with Wilder and Alexis. I wasn't looking for the lowest hanging fruit because, you know, I had a lot of good friends and I had a lot of tequilas with, and you know, they would definitely run this business with me. But I had to go to the guys who was scared of approaching, you know. I was really like, my heart was pounding when I was approaching Wilder. And that's where I got our four or five. So one or three, that's where you go for quality, quantity. Yeah, like in numbers. And once in a while, maybe just making those numbers, you're gonna get a pony, you know, who's gonna be quality as well. But if you're mixing, matching those people in your team, then you'll probably all know that your team is as strong as your weakest point, right? So, since somebody showed me that my time is running up, I'm gonna give you the one last note, and I really hope this sticks with you in your recruiting journeys, is that compromising with people means compromising with results. Compromising with people means compromising with results. Southwestern Advantage is a very good example of that. It's a people's business. And you all be here, I'm pretty sure you're at least three or up. But if you want to bring that out in your managers, in your first years, maybe even OLs who are in your team, then be really critical about them. Are they in their comfort zone? Are they kind of moving from the business category to the playground category? And if you see that, you need to act now. Because playground is how comfortable. And once a person has went from business to playground, it's actually very tough to get them out from there because they have tasted the candy. I think we have time for one or two questions. Oh shit, you guys are advanced. Okay.
Do you do the great team together with your team?
Yes, very good question.
Now I am.
Because I got this idea just a couple of days ago. And really, really, yes. It's really funny, I know, but in a way I have been doing this without being so strategic about it. And now as our team is growing, we have 14 people in our office, you know, I'm looking at it from a totally different perspective. And 2 days ago when I saw this, this really touched me, and I felt like I really have to share this with you guys because this shit is the bomb.
Did I answer the question? So we are going to be doing this with our team. On Monday we're having an OKR meeting, which is objective to some structure. So we're doing this, and then I'm going to propose this to our team as well. Did you have a huge vision before you started? If you saw you get through hard times and make this thing happen when things are not going as well?
So
you get through hard times. How big?
About vision, when you're starting a business, say in Southwestern or in real life, if I may say that, then
You don't have to have a vision. I don't believe you do have to have a vision, but you have to have a thrill to have a vision. You have to want to have a vision. Because with me, the vision came to me as I was working. You guys probably know that, you know, good things happen to people who work. Also, vision happens to people who work. So that's what happened to me.
And what do I do when it's tough?
Will I cry? No. Action cures fear, but I think if things are getting tough, you just need to pick yourself up and work even more, because that's going to help you get through that. And being an UpSteam sometimes gets really, really tough. But what I do then, I just work a little bit more, and in 1 or 2 days it's gone. Also, have a good break sometimes if you need to, but not when you're selling books. That's my time. Cheers. Thank you, guys.